Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Jess. So I have been watching Trisha Paytas for probably like, I'm going to say probably 6 years. I'm going to be talking about today her Louis Vuitton bags. And yeah, if you're interested in that, keep watching, like and subscribe to my channel if you love handbag videos. And yeah guys, I first discovered Trisha Paytas from trying to find like videos about Hello Kitty stores, like the Sanrio store, and I really enjoyed watching her Sanrio unboxings. And just, I was really interested in like shops overseas, because you know, in Australia we didn't have Sanrio store or Hello Kitty or anything. Anyway, that's how I started watching Trisha Paytas, like literally 6 years ago. And I really loved her style back then, and just all the things she was buying, I was really into. She even did a lot of like Louis Vuitton reviews, you know. And guys, I don't know if she still owns some of those bags that she purchased back then, like, you know, 5 years ago or so. But yeah, she has recently done like a Louis Vuitton bag collection. And it's interesting to see the bags that she has at the moment. I feel like she could have gone through some rough times in the past and had to sell off a lot of her Louis Vuitton collection. And maybe she's repurchased a few things recently as well. And yeah, she's definitely like a big lover of Louis Vuitton, and I can totally relate to her shopping habits and kind of buying and selling handbags pretty regularly. And it's just interesting to observe. So in her latest, or her most recent collection video, she has a lot of the newer Louis Vuitton bags. Like she has the On The Go tote, she has even a Nano Terrine, which is a nano style, which was kind of discontinued. It's kind of like similar to the Nano Speedy, but it's a different shape. Obviously it's a nano version of the Terrine bag. You know, little nano monogram bags are still super, you know, hot at the moment, and they've been kind of coming out with those for a while. She has a Pochette Matisse with patches on it, which she said that she hasn't even worn yet. And yeah, it seems like a lot of her Louis Vuitton bags recently, she hasn't even been able to wear them, which is pretty kind of interesting. But that Pochette Matisse she purchased new from the boutique, and I really kind of like that version with the patches. Actually, I'm more into the limited edition Louis Vuitton pieces, so I think if you're going to get a Pochette Matisse, that one was kind of a cool one to get. She even has a Trouville in monogram canvas, so a pretty classic piece, that one. That's was originally designed to be like a cosmetics carrying kind of case or a toiletry case. And guys, you know, I'm obsessed with a denim Louis Vuitton, and she actually purchased a few pieces from Poshmark. She did a video about purchasing pre-loved Louis Vuitton pieces from Poshmark, and I'm pretty sure it was sponsored, but yes, I think she said it was sponsored. And she managed to buy a multicolored Trouville on Poshmark, as well as a denim green Louis Vuitton bag, and I think also the little pouch style that Kylie Jenner has, she bought the green version. And she also bought a pink denim Louis Vuitton bag, which I really love as well. She bought those on Poshmark for, I think she got them for pretty reasonable deals. I think, yeah, some kind of comparable to eBay pricing. But yeah, I don't know guys, we don't have Poshmark in Australia, so do you guys overseas recommend Poshmark for purchasing like things like Louis Vuitton? I have heard that it can be a little bit sketchy, and you can get scammed. So, but it seems like a great place to kind of find these gems. I imagine there's a whole lot of fakes on Poshmark as well. But yeah, she was kind of advocating Poshmark in that video, and it seems that the denim bags, like, yeah, she does really like. In her latest Louis Vuitton collection video, she also had an Alma BB in the vernis leather in like a beautiful raspberry color, which was really nice. And she even has two Alma PMs in kind of brighter colors as well, which they're not as fashionable anymore. I would say the Alma PM, I would definitely say the Alma BB is a bit more, I don't know, not as dated as the Alma PM, but I still think that the Alma PM is pretty classic. It will probably come back again. Just, I don't know, I don't see as many people wearing the Alba PM these days, but it is pretty cool. And guys, she has the Jeff Koons Monet Speedy Bag, which I think is like one of the best kind of colors in that whole Jeff Koons collection. I really liked the Monet print. And yeah, she has owned, I think, probably quite a few Speedies in her life. And this one was a limited edition piece. I think she bought for Valentine's Day from the store. And yeah, really cool piece. Even on the inside, there's like writing. There's a lot of detail in this Jeff Koons collection. I think a lot of people didn't really like it because it's pretty like loud and it's more of a collector's kind of thing. But yeah, I think it's pretty cool she got that Speedy. She has a lot of more basic bags as well, as in like, you know, permanent collection. So she has like the Neverfull in the Damier Azura and a few like tote kind of style bags. And she even has the Thames bag, which she purchased from this website called Luke's DH, which I've never actually purchased anything from that website before. Let me know, guys, if you have. She's purchased quite a few bags in this video from Luke's DH, which she hasn't even cut the tags off them yet. So, yeah, she has this Thames bag, which, yeah, it's a pretty... I don't know why she'd get that bag. It's not really that relevant at the moment. It's pretty random, but anyway, I guess it's just like a basic Louis Vuitton shoulder bag. Yeah, it seems like a lot of the bags in this video she hasn't even really used, which is interesting. She even shows off a kind of upcycled Louis Vuitton bag with tassels. I'm not big on these upcycled Louis Vuitton bags. I mean it's cool if you have a trash Louis Vuitton bag, you want to upcycle it yourself, I'm all for that, but I think kind of spending like over $1,000 for something like that is a bit, I don't know, I wouldn't do it myself. I'd rather just probably buy a new bag, but I think it's kind of cool to upcycle your own bags. I would definitely do that if I ruined my bag. In her most recent videos, guys, she purchased secondhand some Clouds collection pieces, like some luggage pieces. I think she was too late to the party to actually buy these in the store. She totally could if she asked, I'm sure. Like, you know, when the collection was released, a lot of VIP people are able to get their hands on really hot items, and I'm sure they would give priority to Trisha Paytas to get, you know, the new upcoming collections. She was kind of late to the party, and I think she had to pay a premium for some of these Cloud collection pieces. And she even bought like a mesh kind of keep-all bag, which I think she also paid a premium for. I find a lot of these like rich celebrities, they collect the keep-all bags, and maybe she just decided to start collecting the keep-alls. I did notice in her later video that she had a keep-all in the trunks kind of Damier Azura print already, which is pretty cool. But she even recently purchased a graffiti collection keep all. So guys, you know the graffiti, just for visuals, it's this collection. And yeah, I feel like that's something that's come back in fashion, probably because of like Bella Hadid and like the Kendall Jenner been like rocking this kind of print. So she kind of hopped on that trend. And I think getting the keep all is like probably a good like investment. It will probably go up in value quite a bit. She has actually done a lot of bag reviews in the past as well, which I think are really cute to kind of go back and look at. She had a multicolor kind of Speedy bag review. She's also done a review on the Totally MM, which is like a discontinued tote, which a lot of people find is a great mom bag. She even had this amazing Christian Louis Vuitton collaboration bag, which I feel like she probably would have sold, because she did say that she used to have quite a number of Louis Vuitton bags which she had to sell off. And I think only recently she's starting to kind of repurchase Louis Vuitton, just because she got herself into some financial difficulties or something. She even did a review on the Trivoli GM and a Speedy 30 Damier Bean. And even a Manhattan kind of tote, which was kind of a reissue of the Manhattan bag in 2018 with the black handles. That's kind of an interesting bag. I think that's actually a pretty, that would actually be a really good bag to have even today, just as an everyday bag. I like how that bag has the black trim. And also recently I've noticed she's purchased a carry-it bag, which is a new style tote bag, which she said she really loves, and she loves how the handles are kind of longer, she can kind of easily carry it. And she's even purchased recently, I saw she had this like $30,000 haul video, and she bought a Velocite, is it a Velocite BB or something, that little luggage kind of zip around, kind of, it looks like a little bit like a vanity bag. That's actually a really cute bag, I really like that one. And recently she also purchased, I believe, a soft petit mall with that kind of thick multi-pochette strap on it, which was an interesting choice. Yeah, it's kind of a bit, I don't know, I'll kind of enjoy it more when she gets the really crazy bags, but yeah, she's definitely owned a whole lot of Louis Vuitton bags in the past, you know, from whether it's the multi-color collection, where she's got, you know, denim collection, and yeah, I feel like she just loves collecting Louis Vuitton bags. She also has some amazing Chanel bags. She even bought the Birdcage bag. So she's definitely addicted to handbags like most of us. And it's just interesting to see her buying habits, I guess. And it's kind of also a little bit sad because you do notice, as I said, that a lot of the bags she just kind of just kept the tags on or just thrown into her closet. And a lot of them I noticed are quite not really stuffed and they're quite squished in her shelf as well, which, yeah, I don't know if she really enjoys having them or she just enjoys buying them, but anyway guys, who knows. So what do you think of Trisha Paytas' Louis Vuitton bags? Do you like her style? I love watching her, you know, bag related videos, they are my favourite. And yeah guys, thanks for watching my video and I'll see you next time. Bye!